Hi students, I am Pawan, your science master. Today I would like to speak to 7th standard students. Students, in the previous class, what we have talked, please recollect them. Yeah, we have talked about some names of, we have talked about some names of acids and bases. Students, we have learnt some names of acids and some names of bases. So, I hope you have learnt the names of the acids and bases. Students, today I would like to teach you about what are oxides and how bases are formed, and also what are chemical indicators. In this video, what are we going to learn? What are oxides and what are chemical indicators? Students, I would like to explain about what are oxides. Students, in the word itself, you can understand oxides. So that is the product of oxygen. If any material is burnt or reacted with oxygen, a new product is formed, right? That new product with oxygen is called oxide. Okay, for example, in the previous class we have talked about magnesium hydroxide. See the suffix of the word oxide, right? Hydroxide, oxide. What we have talked in the previous class, in the last class, magnesium hydroxide, oxide. So this is the product of magnesium and oxygen. Okay, when magnesium ribbon was burnt, students, when magnesium ribbon was burnt, I am just writing only the formula Mg, magnesium. When it was burnt, when it was burnt in oxygen, so this symbol indicates for burning, heating or burning. So when it is burnt, in the sense, what other element or other substance is involved in this? Oxygen, right? If there is no oxygen, you cannot burn anything. Okay, magnesium is burnt in the presence of air. So, in the presence of oxygen. So, what will be the product? MgO, magnesium oxide. And when magnesium oxide is combined with water, so that gives magnesium hydroxide, that indicates the presence of water. Okay students, oxide, so product of after reacting oxygen. Okay, so magnesium reacts with oxygen and gives magnesium oxide, and when magnesium oxide reacts with water that gives magnesium hydroxide. So finally we can say magnesium is reacted with oxygen and that gave magnesium oxide, and when magnesium oxide is treated with water and that gives magnesium hydroxide. So finally we can say magnesium hydroxide is the oxide of magnesium. Oxide of what? Magnesium. Magnesium hydroxide is the oxide of magnesium. So in the same way, potassium also, potassium hydroxide, same, potassium hydroxide, calcium, calcium hydroxide, next ammonium hydroxide, ammonium hydroxide, 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 hydroxide. Oxide is there, no? So the product ammonium hydroxide or calcium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide or magnesium hydroxide, whatever that oxide is, the product after reacting with oxygen. Okay students, so like this you can understand the hydroxides are the bases. Most of the hydroxides are basic in nature. Okay students, like this you can understand how bases are prepared. Now let me talk about, students don't get confused, you please watch this video repeatedly, you watch this and you will be able to understand. Students, now let us talk about indicators. So we have been talking about indicators to find the nature of the materials, right? First indicators we talked about natural indicators, and in that especially we talked about some petals of flowers and turmeric as well. Okay, and now we are talking about artificial indicators, right? Artificial indicators, these are what? Man-made indicators. So especially we talked about litmus paper, right? In the previous class we talked about what? Litmus paper. It's made up of paper, and chemical indicators are also present. These come under artificial indicators. In the beginning of the chapter, in the beginning video of this chapter, you know that I told you some of the names of chemical indicators. Can you recollect them? Yeah, let me write them. Methyl orange and phenolphthalein. Methyl orange and phenolphthalein. Yeah, these are the chemical indicators. You can see the word methyl orange, you can understand the color of methyl orange is orange in color. Okay, and phenolphthalein, it's a colorless solution, it's a colorless what? Colorless solution, it's in orange color, orange in color, methyl orange. See students, here these chemical indicators are used to identify the nature of different other materials. Okay, so I wanted to share a myth or a superstition present in the society, and you might have seen in villages some people called they are jugglers or magicians. You know, they hold a lemon in their hands and they bring a red color material out of lemon, and they say that's blood coming out like that, you know. But do you think that's really blood? No, we are cheated like that. But that is not blood. They are using some chemical indicators. After reacting that chemical indicator with acid present in lemon, that what is the acid present in lemon? Citric acid, right? After reacting the indicator, methyl orange indicator, the acid is the acid. What is that? Citric acid present in lemon is changing its color into red. Okay. While the magician or juggler cutting the lemon, you know, the juggler uses a knife, right? Before cutting the lemon, he dips the knife in methyl orange indicator. After dipping the knife in the methyl orange indicator and he cuts the lemon, the indicator present on the knife surface, that after, as soon as the juggler cuts the lemon, that indicator reacts with the acid and it gives red color. So then immediately we get surprised. Yes, what the juggler was what the juggler is saying is right, like that we believe. But that's not at all right. They are using this scientific knowledge in that way. So that's their livelihood somewhere. Some people make science as their livelihood, to live their life, to lead their life. They use science in such a way, but that's not good. Okay, students, as we are the science students, you know, you are the science students, you have to think about that. You try to understand. Okay, you have to be a science real detective. Okay, students, we are all the detectives to find the truths happening around us. Okay, right, students. And now methyl orange, it's a colorless solution. Methyl orange is what? Sorry, phenolphthalein is a colorless solution. When phenolphthalein is reacted with some of the materials, and that gives pink color. This colorless phenolphthalein changes its color into pink. If phenolphthalein is changed its color into pink, colorless phenolphthalein gives pink color, then you have to understand the presence of base in that materials. Okay, students. Yeah. To find the nature of the materials using these chemical indicators like methyl orange and phenolphthalein, you have to do an experiment. Okay, you have to do an experiment. Here you have to take two test tubes. And take the extraction of the material in the test tube, extraction of the material that we are going to test, whether the material consists of acid in it or base in it. Okay, see, you have to take two different test tubes and what is this? What we have taken in the first test tube 1 and in test tube 2, two different what? Materials. the materials in the sense the extraction. You can take extraction, okay. And now, what is this extraction? This is another extraction. So, what you have to do is you have to add methyl orange in test tube 1. If it turns red, you have to understand acid is present in it. If it turns yellow, so you have to understand base is present in it. Now you take phenolphthalein, add phenolphthalein in this, and if phenolphthalein, after you add phenolphthalein to this extraction, if it changes or if it remains colorless, that's acid, that consists of acid. And if it changes its color into pink, the extraction consists of base. Okay, students, like this you can find the nature of the materials using these artificial chemical indicators. Okay, students, based on the changes that you observe, you have to write the observations in the table displayed on the screen. Students, you can see that the name of the material or the substance, okay, the material or substance to be written in the first column, and next your observations with phenolphthalein, colorless phenolphthalein and methyl orange in last column. So, what will you observe after you add these indicators to that substances? The changes you observe, right? Based on the change, you have to conclude whether the material consists of acid or base. Like that, you have to classify the materials as acidic or basic substances present in them. Okay, students, like this you have to do, you have to write this experiment in a paragraph form. You have to post your work in the WhatsApp group, and this is for the students. Thank you for listening, and thank you one and all.